Hey guys, it's Ishani, aka Total Makeup Junkie 101, and happy 2018 to you guys. I can't believe it's already the new year. It's about time, because 2017, I have to say, was not a very good year for me, but I am prepared to make 2018 my year. 2018 is gonna be a good year. I'm saying it here and now. I'm putting it out there in the universe. Anyways, today we are going to be starting my Best of 2017 series. As you can see by the title of this video, today we're gonna be talking about eye products. I have a ton of eye products. I'm gonna be going through every single different category and naming one favorite in each and every category. The next video in this series is going to be face, then we're gonna do lips, and then I'm also going to have like a hair care and skincare slash body care type favorites. Let's go through all of the eye categories. Let's start off by talking about my favorite eyeshadow primer. I have oily eyelids, so eyeshadow primer is a must for me. My favorite for a few years now has been the NARS Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. I use this every single time I apply eyeshadow. It is my absolute favorite. It comes in a really convenient little wand applicator here. Super easy to use. It goes on completely transparent. You can't see any color. In general, eyeshadow primer helps your eyeshadow last longer. It helps it from creasing. It makes the pigments more vibrant. So this primer is just my holy grail. It does a fantastic job. If you have oily eyelids, highly recommend. Next up, I want to talk about my favorite cream eyeshadows. Now again, these are products that are not new to my channel. I've talked about them quite a bit. These are the Laura Mercier Caviar Eye Color Sticks. I absolutely love these. These have been my favorite cream eyeshadows to use either as bases or even as a solo cream shadow by itself. These come in a super convenient jumbo stick format. They just twist up and down. I absolutely love the formula. They are super, super pigmented and they glide on super creamy, but when they set, they are budge proof. A couple of my favorite shades from the original line are Amethyst and Copper. Amethyst is a gorgeous metallic purpley taupe, and then Copper is a beautiful metallic copper color. Recently, Laura Mercier came out with their caviar sticks in their matte versions. All of the original versions did have some shimmer or metallic sparkle in them, but the matte versions are also really pretty. One of my favorites is called Caramel. This one is basically a true matte tan brown color, and I love it because it matches my skin tone pretty much perfectly. So if I'm looking for an eyeshadow base to basically just cancel out any of the veins or discoloration on my eyes without depositing any actual color, this does it perfectly for me. Moving into the category of single eyeshadows, I wanted to kind of break up the eyeshadow category into multiple different versions. So we have single eyeshadows, and then we have smaller eyeshadow palettes, and then we have a larger eyeshadow palette, just so I could get in as many eyeshadows as possible. We're just not even going to talk about my obsession with shadows. One that, again, I believe I mentioned this in my 2016 roundup as well. This is the Kat Von D Metal Crush eyeshadow, specifically in the shade Thunderstruck. I actually repurchased this product this year only because my other one had shattered and it was just a complete mess and a disaster to work with. But this is what this eyeshadow looks like. It looks like nothing special in the pan, but it is a gorgeous duochrome white gold color that I love using on my inner corners. Basically, no matter what eyeshadow palette I use or no matter what eyeshadow look I do, I tend to reach for this and pop it on my inner corners. It is just so reflective, so beautiful. It really opens up the eyes. The other eyeshadow single I have been using a lot this year. This is the Bobbi Brown single eyeshadow in the shade Camel. This is a really, really popular Bobbi Brown shade because it is a true medium brown with a very, very yellowy undertone to it. The formula of this is so nice. I actually just take this with a big fluffy brush and just blend it through my crease, and it works as the perfect crease transition color for a neutral eye look. In terms of small eyeshadow palettes, I had to talk about these. These are my favorites. They're the ones I've been reaching for all the time. These are the Dose of Colors Little Eyeshadow Quince. These little palettes have 5 eyeshadows apiece. All of the shadows in all of these palettes are matte, and these are some of the best matte eyeshadows I have tried. This palette I've been holding up here is the Baked light browns palette, some absolutely gorgeous warm toned matte browns. You can get full eye looks just using one of these palettes, but you can also bring these palettes in with a single eyeshadow or potentially a shimmery cream eyeshadow to add some contrast and dimension. The other one I love and have been using for so many months is the Marvelous Mauves palette. This is a beautiful purple toned palette. I did want to go ahead and give a mention to the two new palettes that Dose of Colors just released. They released one called Blushing Berries, which I have used, I believe, 2 times now. Absolutely gorgeous. Love the looks that I've come out with this, but this definitely has quite a bit more darker shades, not so many light tones, so you might not be able to get a full eye look just using this palette. A similar story with the Sassy Siennas palette. Again, you're getting a lot of like medium and slightly darker tones, so you might not be able to get a full look with this palette, but love the quality of these mattes, love the different shade varieties. I honestly have nothing bad to say about these. They're fantastic. That's why they're making it as my favorite. In terms of large eyeshadow palette, maybe this is just insanely repetitive and boring and everybody's gonna be like, eye roll, Ishani. We saw this coming from a mile and a half away. The Viseur Neutral Matte Eyeshadow Palette. Guys, when I say that this is my go-to palette and I literally would keep this palette over any other palette in my entire collection, I'm not lying. This palette has been mentioned over and over and over again. Every time I talk about my favorite eyeshadow formula, Viseur is always there in some way, and this palette probably was squeezed into that video as well because I'm obsessed with this palette. This is the best. I know it looks insanely basic, and that's the thing that I love about it. It is a basic neutral matte palette. The quality of Viseur eyeshadows is basically unbeatable. The Dose of Colors matte formula does come really close though, but this is just a amazing basic palette. You can literally pull it in with any other eyeshadow palette if you're missing highlights, transitions, darker shades for liners. It has everything. This is just my one-stop shop palette. It has been for a few years now, and I love it. Let's talk about my favorite liquid liner of the year. I would have to say I've been reaching for my Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in the shade Trooper quite a bit. This is a little mini size that I have because I think I've used up like 2 full-size ones this year. And while I don't have a full-size one in my collection currently because I am testing some other liquid liners, this is the little mini that I keep in my purse for touch-ups. If my liner tends to like flake or fade or anything, I'll just touch it up with this. Absolutely love the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. It has a little tiny brush tip applicator to it. The formula is nice and black. It's got kind of a satin finish, so not super matte, but not glossy or anything. Dries beautifully, lasts beautifully. I love the applicator. Just everything about this is just fabulous. Love it. Moving on to my favorite pencil eyeliner. 110%, it has to be the Maybelline Master Precise Skinny Gel Pencil. This stuff lasts so well. It is so incredibly thin and skinny. The reason I have 2 out here is because I literally just finished this one today and I threw it in my trash, but then I was like, oh my goodness, if I show them a brand new one and it literally looks like I did not use it at all, people are gonna question me because people always question me over everything. This is the one I completely used up, and you can see I literally, like, I can't twist it anymore because it's gone. So here is my new one that I can actually twist up, and look, product actually comes out. So this is just such a super thin pencil liner. The tip of it is basically as big as something like the Anastasia Brow Wiz or something. It is super thin, very precise, makes it insanely easy to just get your waterline or your tight line without getting black liner everywhere. I love the formula. It's jet black. It glides on nicely. Like I said, it lasts forever. It is waterproof. It is a fantastic pencil liner. I don't see myself ever using anything else because it's cheap and it works. Okay, my next category was favorite mascara, and I actually do not have a favorite mascara of the year. When I was compiling my list of products to talk about in these videos, I started writing things down on a list, and basically everything in every category just came so naturally to me. I didn't even have to think about it. But with mascara, I sat there and thought, and I just just couldn't think of something that I really used this year that I loved. I've just been testing so many different ones that I've never tried before, and none of them have really wowed me. And I told myself that I wasn't just gonna make things up in this video. These are my true favorites, tried and true, the things that I genuinely used and loved this year. And if I didn't have a mascara that I really, really loved, I wasn't just going to mention just any old thing for the sake of mentioning it. Moving on from that, let's talk about brow products. I have two different brow categories. The first one is favorite brow pencil, and my favorite brow pencil has to be the Anastasia Brow Definer. Not the Brow Wiz, the Brow Definer. Now, the Brow Definer differs from the Brow Wiz because instead of having a skinny, thin, round tip on it, this one almost has a tiny little triangle, and it's quite a bit thicker. And I find that if you already have really thick, full brows, sometimes using a really skinny pencil like the Brow Wiz and kind of penciling in your brows looks really, really fake, just because the pencil creates such thin strokes, and my hair is naturally just thick. It's just thick brow hair, so it almost looked obvious. Whereas when I use a slightly thicker pencil and just fill in where I need to and not kind of overdo it, this looks a lot more natural in my brows, and it's super quick to use, very easy, lasts really nicely. I have gone through quite a few of these and I have just nothing bad to say about it. I love it. I will continue to purchase this. And then the other brow category is my favorite brow gel. It's the one that I've just been using for years, and for some reason I just can't get away from it. I'll try something else. I'll try something from the drugstore. You think this is just such a basic category. It's clear. All I need it to do is just hold my brows in place. It doesn't need to deposit color. It doesn't need to look fancy. I don't want it to make my brows look shiny. But the Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel, this is just the best. It's just the one that I have been using for so long. I've never had an issue with it. I love the wand on it. It doesn't hold too much product. It doesn't load your brows down. It's just a really good brow gel, and I love it. Alrighty guys, and the final categories we're going to be talking about in this video are related to false lashes. I have been loving false lashes this year. The first category I wanted to talk about is my favorite lash glue. Again, something you've heard me talk about so much. My House of Lashes clear lash adhesive is just the best. Even most of the writing has worn off of it because I genuinely use this so, so much. It comes in a very convenient applicator with a little brush, so you can just brush the glue on to the strip of lashes, give it a couple seconds to get tacky. This stuff is basically like super glue for your lashes. Anytime I do people's makeup, I always use this lash glue on them, and I've never had a false eyelash fatality on my watch. This stuff literally will hold your lashes in place all day, all night, through the next day if you need it to. It's just the best stuff. And the final category we're gonna talk about in this eye video is favorite false lash style. This was an absolute no-brainer to me, and you'll see why in a hot second, but I love the Red Cherry number 43 lashes. I believe the official name of these is the Stevie lashes, but these are the absolute best false lashes. I just want to show you the way these lashes are cut. So they taper in on the inner corner a lot, and then they fan out towards the edge quite a bit. So they really give your eyes that look of like a true cat eye. It's absolutely gorgeous. If you put on winged liner and then put these lashes on top, it just really complements that wing and just makes it look so glamorous. I find they hold up pretty well. I can generally get 5 to 10 uses out of each pair, which I think is really fantastic. So yeah, I have a lot of these. These are all the Red Cherry number 43 lashes. I buy these in bulk on eBay. I really, really love those lashes. Inexpensive, great quality, beautiful style on the eyes. So yeah, there we have it. That wraps up my best of 2017 eye video. Stay tuned because, like I said, my next video will be my best of 2017 face products. And I have some really, really good face products, so you definitely don't want to miss that video. I will talk to you guys in my next video on Thursday. Thank you guys so, so much for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye.